Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. I am Donatello, and this is The Way. Today's word is coming out of Esther 2, paragraph 12. Before a young woman's turn came to go into King Xerxes, she had to complete 12 months of beauty treatments prescribed for the women, 6 months with oil of myrrh and 6 with perfume and cosmetics. And this is how she would go to the king. Anything she wanted was given to her to take with her to the king's palace. God is saying your time is coming. For everything there is a season. And right now you're in the waiting season. And during the waiting season, there's a lot of preparation that needs to go into this before you meet your kingdom spouse. You need to be sitting and preparing for your king. Prepare yourself for your king. This is going to take 12 months. 12 months to get yourself fully prepared. And I'm not talking about losing weight and getting your hair and your nails, and I'm talking about your mind. This time is needed to transform your mind from a girlfriend mentality to a wife state of mind. There is a difference between being a girlfriend and a wife. If you think like a girlfriend, you're going to attract a boyfriend. If you think like a wife, you are going to attract a husband. Now on the flip side, if you're a man watching this, if you think like a boyfriend, you're going to attract a girlfriend. And if you think like a husband, you are going to attract a wife. What do I mean like think by a husband, think but like a wife? What I mean is you don't just waste your time with someone. You're not just bored so you get into a relationship. You just randomly serial date or get into anyone's bed. No, you're strategic with who you are with, because you know that you are made for someone else. You're not made for everyone. Everyone is not made for you to just go and have fun with. No, we're made for one specific person who compliments us in such a way. Ooh, in such a way that they don't complete us, okay? We're already whole when we meet them. And that's a wife and a husband state of mind, your wholeness. You are good without someone in your life. You are good by yourself. You are financially stable in the fact that you know how to spend your money according to Christ. That doesn't mean you have to have millions in the bank, thousands in the bank, all these things saved up and all these things like rough RIAs and doing all these things with CDs. No, it means that you have yourself anchored in what Christ is telling you, how he tells you to spend his money. 10% out in tithing, right? 10% out in savings, investing, doing things the way he called you to, even if it's on a small scale, right? Because you're in preparation. You're not in the big scale yet. You're still on a small scale. For what he gives you now, show him that you can work with that. Because when you can work with something small, God can give you something big to work with, because he knows that you are trustworthy to do this. And that's the same thing with your kingdom spouse. He's giving you small tasks right now to work with. Small, tiny tasks. But these small, tiny tasks build a very big thing. And then that'll come the time when he says to you, this is your husband. This is your wife. And he gives you a word. And now you know. Because when you know that you're in a season of waiting, but your time is coming, the enemy is going to send attacks in the form of people trying to seduce you or pursue you or trick you to think that this is your spouse, because they want to knock you off your course. Because when your spouse and you meet up, what happens is you guys now are going to push each other in your purpose. It's not now I found them, now I have a purpose. No, you have your purpose before the person. And now the purpose, your purpose is going to help along your spouse's purpose, and his purpose is going to push you along your purpose, and you're going to work together in harmony. And that's the coolest thing, is that someone was specifically picked out and designed for you before you were born. This person was picked out, and the enemy, he's going to try everything in his power to send those DMs, slide into the DMs and try to get you like confused and be like, well, God did say I was going to marry above my social class, just like Esther and just like Ruth. So, all right, then a businessman messages you and he is very successful and you're like, ooh, okay, well, he did say this. And God's like, no, I told you a name. I gave you a name. This name is not the same. Don't get fooled just because that's a little bit. You're here in your social status and this man's here, but what I got for you is all the way up top. Don't miss what's up top because you're settling, because you think that's what it is. Talk to me, communicate with me. The more you communicate with me, the more I will guide you and say, this is it, this is him, go talk to him, or that's not it, back up, back up, back up, right? A wife and a husband mentality is a mentality that knows what their vision is. Even if it's a piece of it, knows the vision, knows the purpose, knows the plan. You will get your vision before you get the vision of who you're supposed to be with. Your purpose will come first, and you will be set in it. You may be in the preparation stages and starting to move into the actual purpose, and that is when your spouse is going to come along, right? And your spouse has to be awakened. Just like in Genesis with Adam and Eve, when Eve was pulled from the rib, Adam was asleep. He was asleep. That's where your Adam is right now. He is sleeping. If he is not prepared and ready, he is asleep. But when he woke up, Eve was presented to him. She was there because he was awakened. And that's the same thing when he is in his purpose and he is in step with the Holy Spirit and he's moving with God and he is just grooving with his mission and his purpose and he's got vision. That is when you and him will be aligned. So you need to make sure that you're prepared, because if he is awakened and he's moving, but you're the one who's sleeping, you guys will just miss each other. You both need to be perfectly in line. Timing is everything, and God's timing is perfect. Just like in Lazarus, he could have went and back to Bethany and seen Lazarus and cured him, but he needed him to die for the glory of God so that he could bring him back to life and show everyone, look, I am who I say I am. I am doing this for God's glory. And your marriage is going to be for God's glory. Your marriage is going to be an example to other people. Other people will come to Christ because of your marriage. Other marriages will be saved because of your marriage, because of what you have gone through in your testimony, how you stayed obedient, how you stayed faithful, and how you persevered when it looked like something else was easier. You said no because you were obedient. Because you stayed firm in your faith, you didn't take the easy route. You knew that this could have been easy. You could have got married, could have been well off, but you wouldn't have been happy. You would have been happy in the moment, but not fulfilled. And you stayed firm in your faith, and God is going to reward you for that. The time of wait feels so long. You've been sitting for 12 months. You've been sitting for 25 years, 30 years, 15, 10, whatever. You've been sitting for so long. And you think it's not coming, and the easier way just seems a better route. At least I'll be married. At least I'll be able to start a family. I'm getting to this age where it's going to be too hard. I might as well just settle. And God is saying, do not settle. Do not run away from that relationship. Run away. Get as far away as you can, because that is outside your purpose. And if you do, just like Abraham and Sarah, trying to help God along with the purpose by getting Ishmael, right? Getting Hagar and having Ishmael, it created a whirlwind of problems that God now had to step in and be like, okay, this wasn't supposed to happen. So you guys thought you were helping the promise. And that's what they said. Literally, he's like, now we can, this isn't happening. I'm getting too old. I'll help. This is the way we're going to fulfill the promise that God gave us. And God's like, that is not what I said. Do not do that. And they still did. They went, had a baby, and now God is picking up all the messes, and he's saying to you, do not be like Sarah and Abraham. Do not think that you're helping fulfill a promise that I have given you. If I promised it, I will give it to you. Just like Isaiah 55:9, as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. As the rain and the snow come down from heaven and do not return to it without watering the earth and making it bud and flourish, so that it yields seed for the sower and bread for the eater, so is my word that goes out from my mouth. It will not return empty to me, but will accomplish what I desired and achieve the purpose for which I sent it. Achieve the purpose for which I sent it. It is going to happen, beloved. It is going to happen. It is already happening. People already know your name. Things are already in motion. You are in a season of waiting. Don't just wait. You're in preparation. Prepare your mind. Become a wife state of mind. Act like you're already a wife and carry yourself in that way. Wives, don't look at other men, right? Wives, don't flirt with other men. Wives got their ish together and their mind set on their husband. That's who they love, right? And until you find your husband and until you find your wife, keep God as your husband. Keep God as your wife. Keep God as that center. and just pull back to him, because he's going to lead you to where you need to be, and he's going to bring your spouse right to you. It doesn't matter if your spouse lives in another country, on another continent. It does not matter if your spouse lives in another state. He will maneuver and move things, manipulate it just for you, so that you and him or her and he can be placed right where they need to be. You are in preparation, my loves. Preparation, people. Preparation. Keep preparing. Keep seeking God. Keep asking him to give you insight into who your kingdom spouse is and to guide you. And remember, this is all about the journey. Don't despise the journey and the preparation and just want to rush to the destination. The preparation is the most important part that leads you to the destination. Without the preparation, there is no destination. So enjoy it. Learn, love, and grow. I will see you guys back later.